this is going to be an ASMR story time. I know it's been a long time coming for this storybook thing, but I picked this up at the Pay by the Pound Goodwill, so it probably cost me like 12 cents or something like that. I liked the illustrations in it. It is called Bedhead by Margie Palatini, and let's hope this isn't painfully awkward. I actually filmed this once before already, but it was so painfully awkward. Every time I do something new, it's painfully awkward. So we're gonna redo it, and hopefully this one is a little bit better. Even if it's not, I'm gonna post it anyway. So you guys can see the pictures. Shuffle, schlump, shuffle, schlump, shuffle, schlump. Schlumped, bleary-eyed Oliver out of bed, down the hall, and into the bathroom. He yawned. He yanked. Whatever that means. Splashed some water, swished some mouthwash, gave his front teeth a passable brushing, and then, in a gunkless corner of the soapy silver soap dish, in a fogless smidgen of his father's foggy shaving mirror, right there on the hot water faucet, for heaven's sake, he saw it. It was big. It was bad. It was. Oliver's hair was out of control, way out of control. There was hair going this way, hair going that way, hair going up, down, around and around. And there was one teeny tiny clump of hair way at the back of his head that looked just like a cat's coughed up fur ball. How can one scream in a soothing manner? We'll figure it out. There's his fam squad eating breakfast. Oliver's scream shook, it rattled, it rolled all the way down the stairs and into the kitchen where Fruit Loops went flying, milk was spilled, spit and sputtered, and two toasties did triple backflips onto the breakfast table. Oliver, 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 shouted Mom, Dad, and Emily as they ran up the stairs and headed for the bathroom door. Mom leaned close to the door, closer. Is everything all right, Oliver? She whispered in her calmest, calm mom voice. Come now, dear. Open the door and let us in. No sound from Oliver. Not a whimper. Not a peep. Please? Said Mom. Pretty please? Pretty, pretty, pretty please? The doorknob slowly turned. Mom smiled at Dad. She gave a wink to Emily. There you go, she said, taking a step into the bathroom. Nothing can be that. Wrong. It was that bad. Yes, sir. No doubt about it, said Dad, surveying the hairy situation from sinkside. Oliver, my boy, you're having one bad hair day. Major, said Mom. Total, agreed Emily. Maybe if we just push it this way, Mom said, giving it a try. Boing. Been there, done that, moaned Oliver. Perhaps if we just pull it that way, said Dad. Boing. Been there, done that, groaned old Oliver. I could curl it, offered Emily, ready to roll. Oliver stared, a steely stare at his sister. I don't think so. Oh, then we'll just wet it, said Mom. Yes, let's just wet it. They all agreed. So they watered Oliver. They splished him and splashed him, gave him a good soak and dunk. Ah, they said, sighing a confident job well done sigh. Oliver's bedhead was now one dripping wet head. And then it dried. Ba-ba-ba-ba-boing, ba-boing, bink, bink, ba-ba-ba-boing. Started going this way, hair started going that way, then up, down, around and around. and there was now a big clump of hair way at the back of his head that looked just like a cat's coughed up fur ball. Oh, a bigger clump than before. I say we spray, shouted Dad, taking aim with a squirt. Yes, spray, spray, cried out Mom and Emily. So spray already, sputtered Oliver. So they spritzed him and sprayed him, and they gooped, glopped, and moosed him. They even hair-pinned him flat in five places for good measure. Ah, they said, sighing, a competent job well done sigh. Oliver's bedhead was now one slick gel head. And then... pins went flying, boing, boing, bing, bing, boing. Hair started going this way, hair started going that way, then up, down, around and around. There was now an even bigger clump of hair way at the back of his head that looked just like a cat's coughed up fur ball. Oliver wondered, maybe if I just sort of, kind of, you know, brush it a bit. No, no, all three shouted, seeing the boy with bristles poised. Whatever you do, no, no. No brush, because we all know that whenever you brush messy hair, it just makes it frizzy. I stopped brushing my hair altogether. Weird, right? Once a week when I wash it, I brush it. That's it. Too late. Oh yes, the brush got stuck. Not stuck in the hair going this way or that. Not stuck in the hair going up and down. Not even stuck in the hair going around and around. But stuck, yes, very, very, very stuck in the clump way at the back of his head that looked just like a cat's coughed up fur ball. Mom gave it a yank, eow. Dad gave it a pull, ow, ouch. And Emily gave it a good long tug, yike. Well, said Mom without a bit of doubt, that brush is stuck all right. Definitely stuck, decided Dad. A done deal, declared Emily. Then just when they were all about to give up hope, Oliver saw the right answer right there on the wall. That's it, he pointed. The hat, go get that hat. So without one more thought of a spritz, spray, or dunk, they all helped Oliver squish, smush, and cram every bit of bedhead, stuck brush and all, into his faithful old battered but true blue baseball cap. Well, almost. Good enough. And with a kiss and a wave, Oliver headed off to school. Everything was fine, everything was dandy. And then... Mary Margaret, who sat in the third row, four seats down, one desk across from Oliver in Mrs. Oppenheimer's class at Biddlemeyer Elementary, looked over to him and said, "You can't wear that hat." Oliver looked over to Mary Margaret. "Can too, cannot." "And just why not?" demanded Oliver, holding tightly onto his hat. Mary Margaret grinned, "Because it's picture day." "Picture day?" stuttered Oliver. "Picture day!" sang out Mrs. Oppenheimer, standing out in front of the class. "Everyone line up for our class picture. Back straight, faces front, smiles wide. And hats off." "Uh-oh," said Oliver. "Hats off? We're waiting, Oliver," Mrs. Oppenheimer said as everyone took their places. "We're waiting, Oliver," said Mary Margaret. "We're waiting, Oliver," said everyone else. "Hey, kid," said the man behind the camera. "Yeah, you with the lumpy looking head. Off with that hat." Oliver hemmed, hee-hawed, but he knew he had had it. He lifted the brim and slowly took off his faithful old battered but true blue baseball cap. He held his breath, he closed his eyes, and he waited. He waited some more. And now I lost my place. Nothing, zero, zilch, nada. He opened his eyes and looked up. There was no hair going this way, no hair going that way, no hair going up, down, not even around and around. And nobody could see the brush stuck in the clump of the hair way at the back of his head that looked like a cat's coughed up fur ball. "Ah," said Oliver, sighing a confident job well done sigh. "Ready, everyone?" sang out Mrs. O. Big smiles and say cheese on the count of three. "One," she said. "Two," she said. And then, boing, boing, bing, bing, boing, 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 boing. His hair started going this way. His hair started going that way. Hair started going up, down, around and around. And the brush that was stuck in the clump of hair way at the back of his head that looked just like a cat's coughed up fur ball let loose and boinged Mary Margaret on top of her head and boomeranged right back into Mrs. Oppenheimer's nose. Three, said the boing to Mrs. O, and then she and everyone else at Biddlemeyer Elementary got a look at Oliver and his bedhead. Jeez. Click. Got it, said the photographer. And you see, this is messy hair. And that's all she wrote, folks. I think I could have chosen a less tongued twistery book for my first one of these, but I just like the pictures. Also, did y'all have those reading groups in kindergarten where like the kids that were good at reading got to be in one group and then like the medium good and then like the kids that were bad at reading in the last group? I was in the bad at reading group, and I had to go to the learning center between classes to like play Hooked on Phonics and stuff. That's my excuse for not being the greatest. My question of the day will be, did y'all have a favorite book when you were a little kid that you like made your parents read you over and over again at night? My favorite one was Pam and Pam. And it was like about these little girls that were friends and they had like dolls. And then they traded dolls, and then, like, they missed their old dolls. I don't know. It was a gem, okay? It was blue, and I just looked it up online the other day, and I could not find it anywhere. Not a hint of it on the internet. No record of its existence. So maybe it was a fever dream. But anyway, if you had a favorite childhood book, let me know what it was. Because I want to know. But I hope that y'all enjoyed. And I hope that y'all have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful weekend. I just wanted to pop in and throw out a big thank you to another one of my wonderful subscribers, Timothy Clardy. I'm sorry, I don't know which pronunciation is correct, but I did receive your donation on PayPal. It took me a little bit to realize it was there because I had my notifications for PayPal turned off. But I appreciate you so much. That was so generous. You guys know that you never have to donate. I don't expect it, but it is really, really appreciated. I make like no money and I live on rice. So yes, that money will come in very handy and it means the world to me. Thank you, thank you, thank you.